Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for today. And we recognize, Father, you created us for one another. And you've given us a unique way in which to express our commitment in covenant marriage. It's with joy that we all come together and we ask your presence to be here with us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
As I said before, this is a wedding. And we are gathered here today in the sight of God to join this man and this woman, Joshua Benjamin McKinney and Alexia Monet Davis, in holy matrimony. This is God's institution. He designed it. He makes the rules on who gets to get married and how it works. And I'm just not making this up. Genesis chapter 2, verses 18 through 24 establishes God's standard. And it says this, "And the Lord God said, it is not good that man should be alone. I will make him a helper comparable to him. And so out of the ground, the Lord God formed every beast of the field and every bird of the air and brought them to Adam to see what he would call them. And whatever Adam called each living creature, that was its name. So Adam gave names to all cattle and to the birds of the air and every beast of the field. But for Adam, it was not found a helper comparable to him. And the Lord God caused a deep sleep to fall on Adam, and he slept. And he took one of his ribs, closed it up, closed the flesh up in its place. Then the rib, which the Lord God had taken from man, he made into a woman." Woman. "And he brought her to the man. And Adam said, this is now bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. She shall be called woman, because she was taken out of man. Therefore a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and they shall become one flesh." Amen.
Amen.
At this moment, I want to establish for each and every person that is here that we're just not here for just ceremony, but we are all here to bear witness to not just their union, but the commitment that they're making and our responsibility to make sure that they uphold what they're saying before God and before us. So what I'm going to ask of each and every one of you, would you say, "We will," when I ask this question? Will you help Joshua, and will you help Alexia in maintaining this marriage that God is establishing for them? Will you respond by saying, "We will"?
We will.
And along with the declaration of intent, I want you guys to listen to what I'm saying and then respond by saying, "I will." Josh, do you take this woman to be your wife, to have and to hold in marriage, to love her according to Ephesians chapter 5 and God's standard found all throughout Scripture, to lead her and serve as a steward of the Lord's instruction and remain faithful until he calls you home? Will you do it?
No, I'm fine. I will.
Boy, don't get whooped. And Alexia, do you take this man to be your husband, to have and hold in marriage, and submit to his leadership, to honor and respect him, walking as an equal, but also as a servant and steward of God's instruction, remaining faithful till the Lord calls you home? Will you respond by saying, "I will"?
I will.
Jumping ahead. Versus "I will." This is your intention. Work with me, girl. Work with me.
I'm just a little excited. I will.
You will?
I will.
All right. Because there's not just two people who have made a decision to come together, but in fact, three. The Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Will you all bow your heads? Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you for what you are sealing in spirit. Father, you knew all of the ins, the outs, the ups, the downs, all of the mistakes, all of the challenges. But you saw this day. You declared this day divine and unique. And the angels now rejoice because yet another man and woman made a decision to do it your way. Father, we stand as witnesses, but we also speak life and blessing to this union. And we are so thankful and so grateful, Father, that you will manifest yourself in them, through them, and you will cause the vision that you have set for them to be fulfilled until you call them home. Again, Lord, we speak blessing to them in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen. My favorite part.
By the authority vested in me as a minister of the gospel, and in so much as you two have committed to marriage by word and deed, in the presence of God and these witnesses, I pronounce you husband and wife. You may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time ever in the history of this planet, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Joshua Benjamin McKinney.
I take you, Alexia,
to be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have in the hold.
To have in the hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For times of favor.
For times of favor.
In evident grace.
Evident grace.
In the times that challenge us.
In the times that challenge us.
In divine health.
In divine health.
In times of sickness.
In times of sickness.
To love.
To love.
Cherish.
Cherish.
And honor.
And honor.
For as long as we both shall live.
As long as we both shall live. First time at this.
Last time. I take you, Josh.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
In times of favor.
In times of favor.
In evident grace.
In evident grace.
In times that challenge us.
In times no that challenge us. What the storm
in divine health.
In divine
health. In times of sickness.
In times of sickness.
To love.
To love.
And cherish.
To cherish.
And honor.
And honor.
For as long as we both shall live.
For as long as we both shall live.
And the reason for it all, I love.